Hello everyone. So today I'm going to explain about our experiment proposal, which is mainly focuses on the game of order arrange. I am Navarasan Seravan and my metric number is BP19110314. So the experiment was conducted based on the Gardner's theory of multiple intelligence and critical thinking. So the determination of this experiment is to find out whether the environmental factor is important to determine the significance of working memory among respondents. So the number of moves represents working memory and the environmental factor is the loud and quieted environment. According to this theory, people encounter different types of external interference and distractions in their lives. During distraction, such as background noise, people talking, dog barking, and the sound of footsteps, it could negatively affect working memory performance. In an article, Working Memory and Language, an overview written by Alan Bradley mentioned that working memory is a multi-component system which includes the central executive visuospatial sketchpad, phonological loop, and episodic buffer. Puzzle games also need the player to use their cognitive thinking to complete all blocks while minimizing move and time. This involves working memory to visualize that could be the next move to put all numbered blocks in its place. Unfamiliar auditory sound is considered as interference to the player when they play the puzzle of game. Interfering stimuli can be categorized into two, which is ignored, distraction, and responded to interruption. According to Zikarik and Thorns, both types of external interference would negatively affect task performance and cognitive processes, particularly when working memory loud was involved. In order to complete the puzzle, participants have to arrange the number of sequences in an orderly numbered block that must be organized by row following the numbers on each block. There are only one block can be moved at one time by sliding it to left, right, up or down. It challenges the player skills of using visual, spatial and mathematical skills to move the block one by one. While we expose to participants to random loud sounds, they might take a lot of more time to think and move more than expected from them. So based on the journal Auditory Distraction and Short-Term Memory, Phenomena and Practical Implications, this is because the cognitive processes of our participants were interrupted by the loud sound that were being played during puzzle games. Moreover, the presence of external sound is directly affecting player moves because the capabilities to visually think of the next step become less sharp. It also can be described as a confluence of processing from eye and ear at the same level, beyond sensory organs. It is known as breakdown in attentional selectivity, where a person trying to concentrate on the memory task, but irrelevant sound intrudes. Disruption is based on what is seen and what is heard are two different things that did not go well with each other, where it affects the working memory while playing the puzzle. In the research we reported, we attempted to test the theory of multiple intelligence and critical thinking by measuring the number of moves taken by respondents in two different environments, which are the cacophonous environment and the quiet environment, to complete the order or number sequences. On the basis of the theory, we predicted that environmental factors would affect working memory. The objective of our experiment is to determine whether the cacophonous and quiet environments directly affect working memory or vice versa. In our experiment, we established four different types of variables: the independent variable, dependent variable, control variable, and extraneous variable. The environmental factors during the experiment is the independent variable in our experiment. We used two different sound environments, which are cacophonous and quietude. We used a loud cacophonous sound to see the influence of the sound and the gameplay. We performed quietude in a silent setting to see if the lack of sound affected the game's play. The dependent variable is determined by measuring the number of movements used by respondents to complete.
Hi, my name is Stephanie Didibong, and I'll explain about experimental design. Experimental design that we chose for our experiment is between subject design, BSD. BSD is an experimental research strategy where participants experience only one experimental condition. The way we conduct the experiment is by dividing 30 participants into two different groups, cacophonous environment and 15 participants into quietude environment. The reason why we chose BSD is because there is no chance of carryover effect. All participants only experience the experimental environment once, so no contamination of variable occur. Not only that, BSD is also beneficial because no bias learning can occur due to our participant never experienced similar experiment before. Lastly, is preventing systematic bias. We randomly chose our participant. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Ashley Angapan. Today I'll be explaining about participant and apparatus. So there are 16 respondents will be selected from different faculties at University Michelle Sabah and will be divided into two groups. All the respondents are from Faculty of Science and Natural Resources, Faculty of Engineering, Faculty of Computing and Informatics, and Faculty of Medicine and Health Sciences. So next will be apparatus. Google Meet will be utilized as a medium to contact and observe our respondents while they are playing the working memory game. A stopwatch will be used to measure reading time. The online game can be accessed via scanning the QR code below. So, thank
you. I'm Pritika here, and my matrix number is BP19160468. So firstly, as for method, we chose the participants from FPSK, FKG, FKI, and FSSA. So each of us found 5 participants for our experiment, so in total there are 30 participants. And we also contacted the participants through WhatsApp, and we separated them into two groups respectively, which is for the cacophonous and quietude environment. So two WhatsApp groups were created, and we added the participants in the group. And we also plan to conduct our experiment during the weekend on a fixed time for all the participants. So before the experiment starts, a Google Meet link will be sent into the WhatsApp groups for the participants to join. So once all the participants join the Google Meet link, the game rules will be explained. So one of the group members will be playing cacophonous sound for the cacophonous environment experiment. And for quieted environment, no sounds will be played, and we will be making sure the environment is very quiet. So once we are done with the game, we will send a Google form link in the chat box for the participants to fill up their details and their scores. Thank you.
A very good morning. My name is Krishanthini Ravindran. My matrix number is BP19110257. So I will be presenting the procedures of our experiment. So the game was played by all members of the squad, and it helped us become more acquainted with the game's procedures. We started to play games according to the levels and learn the difficulties of each levels. So we learned insights about the game by reading written materials about it. For example, we read written material from the Google. So the rules of the game, the designation, the range, and the theory of the game were all discovered by us. This is to ensure that we know the game better. We used loud sound for cacophonous to see the influence of the sound and the gameplay. So we performed quietude in a silent setting to see if the lack of sound affected the game's play. So we discussed to play some cacophonous sound while conducting the experiment for cacophonous environment. As for this experiment, we decided to use honking sound. So vice versa, we plan to remain a quiet environment for the quietude environment. To make sure that we all remain in silent environment, we wanted the participant to mute their microphone but turned on the camera. We also strictly ensure that participants' place is quiet as well. So that's all from me. Thank you.
my name is Muhammad Azfarizal bin Alin, matrix number BP19110251. Significance of experiment. Theoretically, working memory accounts for several types of cognitive processing, including spatial and object processing. The distraction has been shown to be domain-specific, with the strongest interference coming from a distractor within the same processing area. A series of studies examining the effects of visual and auditory distractors on the retrieval of information about visually presented objects. Two types of recovery tasks were examined. In the first step, participants were presented with an auditory keyword, which is pumpkin, and had to decide whether they represented a previously presented object. In the second task, participants had to remember how many examples of ancient objects were displayed on the original screen. Therefore, the first task is a variant of intermodal recognition memory, and the second requires a detailed visual recall. The main result shows that the visual distraction decreased recognition performance, while the auditory distraction did not. As a result, the Weiss and Ghazali article emphasized the point that distraction can lead to less fidelity of the details retrieved from the working memory. The performance of the recognition memory and also the precision of the metacognitive monitoring of recovery were determined in the study by Beeman. Hence, to test the theory, we decide to conduct the experiment in two different environments to observe the significance and performance of working memory among respondents. To justify our experiment, we will also measure the moves taken to complete the game by calculating the number of means among respondents so that we can find out whether the theory aesthetically shows the impact on working memory in different situations. That's all from me. Thank you.